Top half of the second inning we go. Randall Simon with a two-out, two-run single off Brad Penny, and it's 2-0 Chicago. Game two of this National League Championship Series. Mark Pryor on the mound for the Cubs, and Juan Encarnacion digging in, swing and a miss. Encarnacion, 2 of 5 here last night, hit a solo home run, one of the three Marlin home runs in that third inning.
And that was a bullet.
Encarnacion during the regular year hit 270, 19 home runs, career high 94 runs batted in. Here is that bullet you were talking about off his bat in the third inning.
Watch if you can see this thing hit the back wall. You can't because all those guys are watching it hit the back wall. Look at this. Bam! Off the screen out there. It almost knocked it down.
And that one shot into right field. It will drop a fair ball into the corner. Good ricochet for Sosa. Here comes a throw into second. Not going to be in time. Encarnacion runs well. A couple of hits already for the Marlins. And bear in mind, in Pryor's first postseason start against Atlanta, he allowed two hits in the entire game.
This is a little quirk about Wrigley Field. Watch Sammy play the carom off this wall beautifully. He almost has a shot at throwing Encarnacion out because of the way that ball caroms off the wall. Trying to get him not to lunge so much at the plate. Stayed back very well on that one.
He was able to keep that fair because he's keeping his hands inside the ball and trying to go to right center. I think this entire Marlins lineup tonight is going to try to just drive the ball to right center.
Now Jeff Conine. 1 of 4 last night, had a triple and a run batted in. 5 for 19 in the postseason. He hooks that one into left field, a base hit, and they will hold up Encarnacion at third. So just like that, here come the fighting fish from Florida. Runners on the corners and nobody out. The Dusty Baker before the game last night, before the game again today, singing the praises of this club under Jack McKeon. He said, boy, that is one good ball club. And Jack McKeon said it's the finest group of guys he has ever been around in all his years managing in the major leagues. And you got to bear in mind, although Jack last managed in 2000, he has managed a lot of big league games.
72 years old, McKeon is. Been around a while.
Real complimentary of the bench guys, role players like Banks, Fox, Lenny Harris, Mordecai, Redmond.
Number 8 hitter in the Florida lineup is Alex Gonzalez. Later, Jack in his 845 wins, but none bigger than last night. It's the first time he's managed in the postseason. 0-2.
This is why the National League, in my opinion, is the superior league. Even though it's first and third and nobody out, Pryor realizes by either infield pop-up or keeping the ball in the infield or a strikeout, you have the pitcher on deck, probably a strikeout. You can get out of this with no damage.
And how does that make it superior to the American League?
Because
the pitchers can't hit?
Because 3-2 is better than 12-8.
All day, every day, I'm with you, Al. Swing and a miss, that's a huge out.
I don't know where you guys were, but I saw a 9-8 game last night that was pretty good.
But it took 11 innings. Let's send it to L.A. Here's Jeannie Zalasco.
Mike Mussina in a bit of trouble in New York. Two on, courtesy two walks in the second inning. But the Moose cleaned up his own mess. No score at the stadium. Bottom two.
Boy, good thing Mussina got the throw to the pitcher there to get out of that mess.
Well, here is the pitcher, and he can't swing the bat, Brad Penny. He had 9 hits during the regular season, had 2 home runs, and 8 runs batted in. Squares around a bunt, and it's strike one.
You brought this up, Al, getting to this point. Do you want him to put the ball in play? Are you trying to get a double play out of him, or do you want to strike him out? You got to face Pierre.
I want to strike out, and if that square around bunt is for McKeon, that's a great call. This is a safety bunt. Putting the ball in play, and Encarnacion's going to see where the ball ends up. That way, even if you can see the out at first, the second and third with two outs with Pierre coming up. He puts the ball in play. There's a good chance he's going to put it on the ground. Double play.
Well, Penny took the first pitch for a strike after swearing around, made contact the next time, and fouled it out of play.
The reason why it makes sense, too, is because the shortstop has to cover second. The third baseman comes in if he has to field the bunt. Encarnacion can run as far as the third baseman will run. He's not worried about getting picked off.
Butcher Boy, a swing and a foul ball out of play. Penny taking a look down at longtime Chicago White Sox star shortstop and the Marlins third base coach, your old buddy psycho, Ozzie Guillen.
You talk about a guy with some sweet hands. Easy Gonzalez. Both Gonzalez's in this game. The shortstops are excellent. That man could flat out pick it.
0-2 to Penny. Struck him out on a curveball. Prior back-to-back strikeouts. After runners were on the corners with nobody out. Time for our sprint virtual manager question. If you were a manager, which bullpen would you want of the four remaining playoff teams? Marlins, Cubs, Red Sox, Yankees. To answer, use your PCS Vision phone from Sprint or log on to foxsports.com, keyword MLB on Fox.
I'll tell you, I have Danny Evans on speed dial. He's the general manager of the Dodgers. I'm going to try to get their bullpen. Is that a possibility?
Or you could call Jerry Hunsicker in Houston and try to get Dotel and Wagner.
I'll still take the Yankees.
Because of Rivera?
Rivera.
Runners on the corners, and now Juan Pierre, the batter. 0-1. Popped up and out of play. Told you last night, Pierre very tough to strike out. Not that that's this big of a deal right now. You already have two outs in the inning. But Pierre is going to put the ball in play, and anything can happen thereafter.
And I think that's what the point that I was asking you, Al. I know if you let the pitcher put the ball in play, there's a chance he gets a hit and drives in a run. But if he bounces it to your shortstop, you get the double play, you're out of the inning. You don't have to face this leadoff hitter with guys on first and third. And his chances of putting the ball in play are much greater.
Up and Pryor is going to get out of an early jam for the second straight inning. The Marlins lead 2-1.
Welcome to the design studio of the late, great Harley Earl. Mr. Earl designed concept cars, luxury cars, sports cars, family cars, cars with wings, fins, cars with turbine-powered engines. Every kind of car you could possibly imagine.
Not every kind. Let's give him something new to talk about.
Introducing Rainier. It's a brand new Buick.
Program in the first. $4.
Summer wind.
Snacks in the fourth. $25.
From across the sea.
A soda at the end of the seventh. $3.
It lingered there.
Friday night, no TV, DVDs, or video games.
And walk with
priceless.
Me.
There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's
all
MasterCard, devoted fan of Major League Baseball.
To guarantee their verdict, they hired an expert from the outside.
Find something on every one of them.
But the one thing they didn't predict was someone on the inside.
The jury's mine,
and I can push it either way.
For a price.
From the best-selling thriller by John Grisham, John Cusack.
I can't protect you.
Gene Hackman.
I want you to find her.
Dustin Hoffman.
I know you're playing both sides.
Rachel Weisz.
Anyone can be gotten to.
You're losing me, my jury!
Runaway Jury, directed by Gary Fleeter. Rated PG-13. October 17th.
Another big game. He's out of there.
I've made a lot of news on the baseball diamond. But if you want to find out about this diamond, you've got to go talk to your doctor.
Ready to try Viagra for the first time? See your doctor and find out if a free sample is right for you.
My doctor says it's right for me. That's why I stay with it. For more information, go to Viagra.com.
The League Championship Series on Fox, brought to you by State Farm, providing insurance and financial services like a good neighbor. State Farm is there. By MasterCard, there's some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard. By One Runaway Jury, October 17th, only in theaters. And by Viagra, step up to the plate and ask your doctor if a free sample of Viagra is right for you. Bacco, first pitch swinging down, strike one to Brad Penny. The Cubs in front, 2-0.
After Penny having a 28-pitch first inning, I'd like to see, especially in the bottom of the order with Trier up, to make him work a little bit. 28-pitch inning is high. At that rate, after five innings, he'll have 140 pitches.
That's some outstanding math skills you just dropped on us right there.
I used your calculator.
One and one to Bacco. Hitless in the postseason. 0 for 7 overall. Hitless in 3 at-bats here last night. 1 and 2.
With the left-handed Bacco, if you see Encarnacion, he's playing very deep, and as much as Penny goes away, he's not going to pull the ball.
Up the middle, Castillo able to cut it off, but no chance to throw out Bacco. An infield hit to open the Cubs second.
Now, once again, we've seen two plays where they were both base hits on ground balls up the middle, but the quickness of the defense of this Florida Marlin middle infield. Look at this. Look at where this ball is. That's just a base hit up the middle. You have no business going up and getting that ball, let alone thinking you might throw the guy out. These guys are so quick. What makes a pitching staff better? Great defense.
Breyer had 7 sacrifices during the regular season. Fouls this one away. Strike one. Mark hit a home run. Knocked in 6.
The high fastball, your best four-seam fastball about letter high, to me, is the most difficult pitch to bunt softly and not pop it up. A lot of times a catcher will call a curve or a slider. You keep that ball on the ground. You elevate a high, hard fastball. It's hard to keep it soft.
That fastball looked like it was down, and Fryer able to lay it down.
It's a good bunt. Great bunt.
While we have a moment, we'll send it back to Los Angeles. Here's Jeannie Zalasko.
Tim Wakefield faced 5 batters, bottom 2 in the Bronx, but the Yankees couldn't take advantage. They left 2 on as Nick Johnson ground out. We have no score. Top 3.
During this season, in the 19 meetings between Boston and the Yankees won 10, the Red Sox won 9.
And why the National League is better? Execution. We have a pitcher who laid down a great bunt. Runner now in scoring position. Let's see what Lofton does with it.
I know in the American League that DH would just come up and swat one into the seats. You have 2 runs.
Oh, that's blow it away. Hold a ball. That looked like a pretty good pitch.
Penny's talking to himself after that pitch as well.
Here's a pitch. It's on the corner. Let's see if it's the right height.
A little low.
Might have been low. I'd like to see the side shot on that.
Well, there's no question, Al. He is all over the place. You can see the side swing, the side view of that last pitch that you wanted to see if it was lower than his knees.
Third, second, 1 away, 2-0, the count on Kenny Lofton. Bouncing ball up the middle, Gonzalez has it bounce over his head, and scoring is Bacco to make it 3-0. That ball took a funny hop.
My Gonzalez was going to get to that ball too, and he should have, but that took a very strange hop back to his right and over his head. This might come right into your living room. This might be the greatest view you're going to see of it. Watch it bounce back to his right, up, look at that. He's just saying, where did it go? Watch his feet. His feet tell you where that ball goes. Look at him try to turn his hips all the way back to try to get back to that ball.
Talking to the infielders, this infield is one of the worst in the sense of getting hops like that in the National League.
Strike one on a check swing, appeal to fielded culprit to Mark Resolano.
From the center field view, check swing. Didn't look like a real strong effort to go after that ball.
Cubs in front, 3-0 here in the bottom half of the second inning. Lofton a single and an RBI after the Cubs got two off Brad Penny in the opening inning. Runner goes. Breaking ball taken, and Pudge will not even bother to throw.
And you know, Tommy, that does not surprise me at all, because I think Kenny Lofton, who is the active leader in stolen bases, if you don't count Ricky Henderson, has been inspired by what he saw in Pierre and Castillo yesterday. And he said, you know what? I will be getting in on this kind of fun for the rest of this series. And I think you're going to see him doing a lot more running the rest of this series, because he doesn't want to be shown up. He's the master teaching the kids.
Breaking ball and a broken bat roller to the right side. Castillo will throw out Resolana, getting Lofton down to third, two out in the inning. Tomorrow, baseball's postseason continues at 8 o'clock Eastern, 5 Pacific. Game 2 of the American League Championship Series between Boston and New York. Derek Lowe against Andy Pettitte. Then Friday at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific, Game 3 of the National League Championship Series. We move to South Florida. Kerry Wood for the Cubs against Mark Redmond of Florida. Sports biggest month of the year continues tomorrow night only on Fox. 0-1 to Sammy.
Lofton now needs just two more stolen bases in the postseason to tie Ricky Henderson as the all-time leader in that category as well. Ricky stole a base in the postseason.
Of course, a lot of Ricky's postseason appearances were long before there was an extra layer of playoffs, before we had the advent of the wild card and the division series, which began in 1995.
But also when there was a greater emphasis on the stolen base.
High drive, straightaway center. Sammy plays long ball.
Florida Marlins don't think Sammy can get on top of a good fastball up in the zone. This is not up high enough, and Sammy can still get to that one. Crushed.
Breaking ball in there. A strike.
He took the first pitch strike, fastball down the middle of it. With the runner in score position, I don't know why he swung, or he didn't swing, and now I know.
495 feet.
Ball hit on top of the camera well house out there. It hit behind it and bounced back.
Ball in the air to short right field, and Encarnacion's got it. That'll end the inning. Two in the first, three in the second. You can watch baseball a long time here at Wrigley Field, and very few home runs will travel further than that.
I was working in the garage and I smelled smoke. I quickly determined it was a grease fire. I knew grease fires were different from other type blazes, but I wasn't sure the best way how to handle such a conflagration. So I asked myself, what would Jared do?
I'd get a veggie delight on wheat, or maybe with the honey oat bread. Sorry, what was your question again?
The veggie delight from Subway. Eat fresh.
Okay, remember, we're just checking out prices.
So no matter what they say, we're not buying yet.
Right. What's running through your veins?
Ice water.
Right. Okay, face.
So with Circuit City's Price Match Plus, you're covered on price.
Well, take it.
Go ahead, take it. If you find a lower price within 30 days of purchase, we'll give you back 110% of the price difference. Circuit City, we're with you.
Nice game face.
She didn't even see it coming. You hear that?
Go that way.
Right there.
The Corolla. It's not the destination. It's the drive.
She came from over there.
The dental experts at Oral-B are on a mission to protect your teeth and gums. Their ultimate weapon? The new Oral-B Professional Care 7000. The world's most advanced power toothbrush. With a compact round head like dentists use, its unique pulsing 3D action cleans below the gum line, preventing and even reversing gum disease. Mission accomplished. The new Oral-B Professional Care 7000. Brush like a dentist.
This October, Fox is telling these beautiful European women that this $11,000 a year cowboy is worth $80 million in oil. We lied. Again.
And now to the best part, he's rich.
The next Joe Millionaire, an international affair. Monday, October 20th on Fox.
Sammy Sosa with a monster two-run home run to straightaway center field. Without a doubt, as that ball is popped up down the left field line, Gonzalez will wave off Alou, and Castillo retired one away. Steve, I worked here every day for 6 years and used to hear our friend Ron Santos say many, many, many times, and even going back to his playing days in the 1950s, Roberto Clemente was the only player he can remember to hit a ball over that camera well in straightaway center out near the scoreboard.
And the scoreboard is a good distance past even where Sammy hit that ball. Oh, look at Kenny Lofton. He can't believe how far it went. They said that Clemente's ball may have hit the scoreboard, but it was off to the left of it. You see the distance between where Sammy hit it and where that scoreboard is. That's a long ways.
Shot into right field, a base hit for Ivan Rodriguez.
And what else is new? Pudge went the other way and got another base hit.
Well, don't forget, the Marlins fell behind in the game last night. 4-0 at the end of one. When they came to bat in the third inning, they had one on, one out, and scored 5 runs. There's one on, one out, third inning of game two.
However, Mark Pryor is on the bump, the mound.
Breaking ball, strike one to Derek Lee. Pryor, an 18-game winner, as we mentioned, during the regular season at a 2.4 ERA. Opponents hit 231 against him. He only allowed 15 home runs. Jammed Lee with that pitch. Two away.
We talked about this exact scenario in the opening of this show and comparing it to last night's ballgame. Al, you said you don't think Pryor's going to spit it back up if he gets an early lead like he has right now. And Josh Beckett for the Marlins in yesterday's ballgame totally rediscovered himself, settled down, and reinvented himself as a pitcher on the mound and did the job. We have not seen Brad Penny showing us any signs that he's going to do that so far.
Well, Miguel Cabrera had a pretty good at bat his first time up. The end result, not what he had in mind. An 8-pitch at bat, he wound up striking out.
For Pryor, when you're up by this amount, you want to make sure you establish getting ahead and put the ball in play. You don't want to walk guys. You want to be basically crisp enough where the defense is on their toes and not their heels. And the Marlin lineup has to look at it as though it's not a five-run deficit. He's have to do what Pudge did by staying on the ball, still playing small ball in the sense that you're trying to go to right center and up the middle. Can't hit a five-run homer.
47th pitch of the game from Pryor. 1-2 to Cabrera. Breaking ball, grounded foul. That's the old adage about, peck away. Just peck away. You get one here, maybe you get two the next inning. Then you're a walk and a bomb away from tying it up.
What's he do right here, Al? He's got him 1-2. He threw on the breaking ball right there. It wasn't his good one, the big sweeping one that goes away and actually ends up out of the strike zone. Or does he just buzz him with a high fastball here?
That's what I would do. I would see how aggressive he is. And again, in the incident of being down five runs, I'd elevate with a high fastball. Curveball.
There's the big sweeper. He usually gets people to swing at that pitch. This kid, Cabrera, is showing us a great job. You mentioned it last at-bat, how unaggressive he was. Once he got to two strikes, he was a much better hitter doing the same thing in this at-bat. That's a tough pitch to lay off.
He shortens his stroke, and he's going up the middle, preferably right center.
Into right field, a sinking liner caught by Sammy, and that'll end the inning. One hit, one man left. We head for the last of the third, and the Cubbies out in front by five.
May I say one thing?
Hubbard and Roper give Kill Bill two thumbs way up. Rolling Stone raves, wildly funny and adventurous.
I'm fine, baby.
How was school?
And Newsweek declares it's astonishing.
No kidding. Now, if any of you've got anything else to say, now's the time!
Quentin Tarantino's Kill Bill. Rated R. In theaters Friday.
So what did the doctor say?
He said that the pain that wakes me up when I move at night is from arthritis.
Really?
He said I should take a leave.
Not Tylenol?
The doctor said Tylenol can wear off in the middle of the night. Aleve works all night.
Doctors know Aleve has the strength to stop arthritis pain for up to 12 hours, so pain won't interrupt your sleep.
I see the Aleve worked.
All night long.
Aleve. And for all-day non-drowsy relief of your tough cold symptoms, try Aleve Cold and Sinus.
Hi, guys. KFC.
Check this out.
Cool laptop.
Cranium kazoo.
Hey, there's chicken in here.
It's too easy.
Finally, a kid's meal that's fun for kids and moms. KFC's Kids Laptop Pack. Real chicken, a side dish, Mott's applesauce, fruit by the foot snack, and a Sierra Mist. Just $2.99.
Mom, did you?
The square meal in a fun box. Only at KFC.
On the road and stuck trying to get business email in all the wrong places? Get Verizon wireless email access and your data will travel on America's most reliable wireless network.
Can you hear me now? Good.
For all your company's wireless needs, we mean business. Verizon Wireless. We never stop working for you.
It's the story of a family that lost everything.
They are going to keep Dad in prison. Also, they're going to have to put a halt in the company's expense account.
And the one son's sane enough to pull him through.
Interesting. I would have expected that after they're keeping Dad in jail.
Arrested Development.
I'm having the time of my life.
Hey, T-Bone.
Sunday, November 2nd on Fox.
Bottom half of the third inning we go with the Cubs leading Brad Penny and the Marlins in game two of this National League Championship Series, 5-0. Two runs in the opening inning on a bases loaded, two out, two run single by Randall Simon. A one out RBI single in the second by Lofton. And then a monster home run to straightaway center field off the bat of Sammy Sosa.
For as disappointed as Brad Penny is right now, obviously be down by five in the third, he has to get back to banking his pitches and realizing the deeper he goes into the game will help and save his bullpen for the rest of the series.
Boy, now you know how important that is. I mean, these series can turn into lengthy, grueling, taxing series on bullpens especially.
Well, with the off day tomorrow, that's going to help him better. Being ahead two innings yesterday with 28 pitches, and Fox threw an inning in two-thirds with 33 pitches.
Two and two. That's why it is so critical, as Nate Bump now will begin to throw in a Marlin bullpen, to have your big guns deliver big-time games and pitch deep into games. I mean, who could forget the greatest pitching performance by a team in the history of baseball during World Series play occurred 2 years ago. The top two of Curt Schilling and Randy Johnson, both of those guys going 7, 8, 9, and the Cubs are banking on the same thing from Pryor and Wood.
Was a hanging curveball, but sometimes a hanging curveball could be good in the sense that it's so high the hitter sees it as a real juicy pitch to hit and it stays high enough where they can't get the bat hit on it.
2-2. Overthrew a fastball there. Full count.
It's a release point. It's around the curveball a little bit, which is okay so long as you're finishing. To me, that's just an overthrown curveball. Brad is trying to throw it 100 miles an hour as opposed to letting the grip do the work.
That one launched deep into the night as well off the bat of Ramirez. It is 6-0 Chicago.
Tommy, it's going to be a long, long night, or quite possibly a short night for Brad Penny if he's going to challenge guys like Sosa, Alou, and Ramirez with that pitch.
And stress that pitch.
Fastball's okay. Down Broadway, not in that location.
Hooked into right field by Simon.
First pitch swinging.
Good curveball. Went down and got it.
Short night at the same time for Brad Penny. He does not survive the third inning. Nate Bump will come on from the bullpen. All Chicago so far in game two.
If you think all batteries are the same, consider this. When the Rocky Mountain Rescue Group needs light to save lives, they trust Duracell. Out there or right here at home. Duracell, trusted everywhere.
The Red Wine Vinaigrette Club. It will not make up for anything that happened at the bachelor party. But with under 6 grams of fat, it'll more than atone for your recent deep-fried badness. Subway. Good. So you don't always have to be.
In my dream, I'm in a museum.
Executivus obsoletus.
Executivus obsoletus.
He's extinct.
I'm extinct.
His inability to adapt to the rapidly changing business climate proved his downfall.
What does it mean?
You need to adapt fast or perish.
Perish?
Or be acquired.
I'd rather perish.
Let's go see the woolly mammoth.
Check this out. I'm sitting next to your new boyfriend. Don't you just love your new boyfriend?
I do love him.
As long as you're happy.
Picture mail that talks from Sprint. At Sprint stores, choose from a wide selection of picture phones starting at $99.99. Share it when it happens.
It's always been our dream to run a bed and breakfast.
that I had to go on chemo, and it just drained me.
If you're on chemo and feel tired, you may be anemic.
We even talked about canceling our guests.
Talk to your doctor about Procrit for chemotherapy-related anemia in patients with most kinds of cancer. Procrit helps rebuild red blood cells, and more red blood cells can mean more strength.
Here come the meals.
Procrit is proven and safe. In studies, only diarrhea and edema occurred more often with Procrit than placebo.
Here, there's no slowing down.
Thanks indeed to the Steel City. Three former Pirates at the beginning of the year in the lineup in October for the Cubs here tonight as Nate Bump takes over on the mound. He was not on the division series roster. And the rookie right-hander comes in trailing 6-0. Bump came over from the Giants in exchange for Levon Hernandez in 1999, a former number one pick by the San Francisco Giants.
This is an unusual move, in my opinion, Tom, to see the pitching change this quickly. Kenny doesn't have it. There's no question about that. But you're either going to see Nate Bump and Tejada go out there and throw about 4 or 5 innings in this, or you're going to see him use everybody 1 or 1 1/3 inning. Because, in my opinion, you're not coming back to win this game against Pryor. So you either leave Penny out there, or you better do one of two things. Use two guys that you're not planning to use the rest of this series. Nate Bump may be one of those guys. Or you throw everyone you have for one inning, because you cannot burn up your bullpen, whether you have tomorrow off or not.
See, Boston has jumped in front of the Yankees 2-0. Swinging a foul ball back out of play. Game one of that American League Championship Series. And Boston, after being dominated by the Yanks the last number of years during the regular season, gave New York everything it wanted and then some this year.
Yes. Now what is he going to do here, do you think, as far as what his bullpen's concerned now? Does that guy stay out there and throw 3 innings?
No, I think he's going to go 1-1-1 with Pavano, Helling,
Johnny Holstaff. Everybody's going to get a chance.
Tejada. You're right. With the one day off, it's not that much, especially if you end up, if they start really continue to hit, you're going to pull a couple more guys and they throw too many pitches. Now it affects Friday. But you still have 4 guys that haven't thrown. He's hoping he can get basically 1-1-1-1 out of them.
Well, that looked like a pretty good breaking ball right there, and Pudge held it to give Chuck Merriweather another look.
Curveball that, well, I like it.
That might have even fooled Pudge a little bit. Watch him go up and then back down to his knees to get it.
Popped up, foul territory, and out of play. Still 3-2 on Alex Gonzalez. The Cubs with an early 6-0 lead. This Cub team had a hard time scoring runs during the regular season. They averaged just at 4.5 runs per game. And here in the first 2 games of this league championship series, flexing their muscles. 14 runs in 13 innings. Two again, and a ground ball should be 2. Look at Gonzalez. Took a steal. How about that? And they call the runner safe at first. While we have a moment, let's send it to Los Angeles. Here's Jeannie Solasco.
Well, I know you saw the score from New York, so I'll stop the agony. And so did David Ortiz. 2-for-21 in his postseason coming into this at-bat. And he's bringing Manny Ramirez home with him. A 2-run shot. It's 2-0 Red Sox, top 4.
When was the last time we were watching baseball on a night in October where both the Cubs and the Boston Red Sox led a series, led a game,
or even playing?
On the outside corner, a strike.
Take another look at the tremendous defense by Gonzalez. Look at the flip with his glove to Castillo. Castillo with his back to the play. Boy, that was a closer play at first than it looked at first. That could have been a bang-bang double play.
Low and away to Bacco. 1-1-1.
Plays like that are the reason why the Florida Marlins are in the NLCS. Great defense, especially up the middle, will always keep you in the games and also make a pitching staff better.
Many have said this is the best defense up the middle of any team in Major League history. Some have made that argument.
Who's arguing?
You know, you go back to the days, for example, of the Big Red Machine, and some might say that they had Cesar Geronimo in center field, who won 6 straight gold gloves. They had Davey Concepcion, who won almost 10 gold gloves at short. Joe Morgan, a multi-gold glove winning second baseman, and the greatest defensive catcher to ever play, in my opinion, Johnny Bench. In the air, left center field, hit pretty well, and off the ivy. Rounding third and coming home is Gonzalez on a double by Paul Bacco. Seven nothing Cubbies.
Fastball down and away. Bacco just going right with it, dropping the bat head through the zone and letting this summer night, or the way it feels, let that ball just drift into the gap and keep going and going. Boy, nobody, as far as Cub fans are concerned, can probably remember a night like this in October that feels like the summertime. Usually it's bitter cold and the wind blowing in by now.
Strike call to Mark Pryor, all 7 runs. Charge to Brad Penny in his 2-plus innings. Hit down the right field line and out of play. Nothing in 2 to Pryor.
Well, Tommy, if you said that in your era of baseball, the best player that sits behind the plate is Johnny Bench, then the second best is the kid that's sitting behind the plate right now.
Yep. And some would say that Rodriguez is the better defender between the two.
10 gold gloves. The only guy, in my opinion, in the game today that can change the game defensively. There are very few guys that change baseball games when they don't have a bat in their hand. He's one of them. Take your running game and put it in your back pocket.
You see Rodriguez tied with those 10 straight gold gloves with the aforementioned Johnny Bench.
Talking about the defense up the middle, of course, catcher being that part of that scenario, it makes the pitching staff better because you don't worry about so much the runners on base, even if they're green runners, runners that steal a lot and can get good jumps. When you got a catcher like that behind home plate, go ahead, run.
Slow roller by the mound. Castillo throws out Pryor. Two away, and Bacco on to third. We invite you to play Hit the Pros, presented by Chevy Silverado, and face real pitches from today's best hurlers. Log on to FoxSports.com, keyword games, Chevy Silverado. It's the right truck. Get a look at the Windy City. What a spectacular city it is. Mark Pryor with a 7-run cushion, and we're just in the last of the third inning. Strike one to Kenny Lofton. If you're wondering, only twice this year has Mark Pryor had a game where he allowed 6 runs or more. Against the Houston Astros on May the 23rd, allowed 7 runs in 6 2/3 innings. And against Atlanta on the 11th of July, that was the game he had the collision with Marcus Giles, gave up 6 runs in 4 innings. Base hit left field. Pryor has not allowed 8 runs in a game. And it's 8-0 Chicago.
Same thing. Kenny Lofton, outside corner. Let me just slap it into left. Same thing that Bacco did. All we're doing right now is hitting the ball where you're pitching it.
Especially with two strikes.
Shorten down, hit the other way.
Resolonic is singled and grounded out to Castillo at second base. That one comes all the way to the backstop, and Lofton will advance on to second.
Fudge kind of came up on that one. We'll rarely see him do that, but it was a fastball. Toughest ball to defend is a fastball in the dirt because you don't expect it to be there.
Well, he stayed down on one last night in a critical part of the ball game. You wonder if an inning like this is just kind of getting his mind off the situation and being a little frustrated. Because he didn't stay down on that.
Get me out of the way.
Drop to their knees, collapse. Turn your shoulders in like a shell of a turtle.
One and two on Greselonic. Nate Pump on in relief of Brad Penny, who had his second straight disappointing postseason start here tonight. Swing and a miss, and that will end the inning. But not before the Cubs get two in the first, three in the second, and they tack on three more.